This is Tim Bryce with my column entitled Job Check, 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 and Check. It used to be if you wanted a job, you would simply complete an application form, attach a resume, come in and have an interview, and you would either be selected or dropped from consideration. Case closed. However, due to our litigious society and hyperactive human resource departments, it is no longer that simple. In fact, it can be a downright painful process. Aside from the application and interview, there are typically seven types of background checks to verify your credentials. First, there's the employment check to verify the past jobs you've held. HR will ask for references, but this is something typically not offered anymore as it might lead to a lawsuit. For example, if the job candidate is said to be a good worker by his previous employer but turns out to be a dud, the former employer could be sued for false representation. Conversely, if they say the candidate is bad, they could be sued for character assassination. Consequently, companies rarely offer references anymore, just verification of employment, including the dates they worked and the job titles they held. Next, we have an academic check. Falsifying academic records for the purpose of employment is a crime, and companies take this very seriously. I knew a classmate who falsified his college records and was caught. This cost him dearly, not only in terms of crime and punishment, but in prestige among the members of our class. It is embarrassing, and it's just plain wrong. Next, we have craft check. Sometimes it's necessary to demonstrate the knowledge of your craft. For example, if you're a programmer, you may be asked to take a technical test to verify your knowledge and demonstrate your skills. If you're a technical writer, you might be asked to solve a test case. Even if you have a certification or a degree in a particular subject, be prepared to demonstrate your knowledge. Next, we have a criminal background check. Now it gets interesting. Most medium to large companies today perform a criminal background check. When interviewing, do not lie about your checkered past, as it will surely come to light. Discuss your problems of the past frankly and openly. The doors will not always close in your face for a past indiscretion, but the company definitely wants to know about it. Next, we have a drug check. Many companies today insist on a drug-free work environment, not to mention alcohol as well. Consequently, you will be asked to pass a drug test, not just before being hired, but as an ongoing program within the company. Look, it's simple. Do not come to work stoned or drunk. Then we have a credit check. Companies often run a credit check on new employees just to see how well they manage finances. A low credit rating could detect a potential problem and risk to the company, hence another reason to manage your finances. And finally, a social media check. This is the one check most young people overlook. What you post on social media, such as Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and so on, will be reviewed by your employer. If there are some risque photos or comments on your site, remove them now. If you have photos or videos showing tattoos that might offend people, eliminate them. This category alone is the most overlooked by young people and probably the greatest threat to a candidate being hired. Even after you've been hired, if you post pictures of a drunken party you were at over the weekend, you can expect a phone call on Monday morning. If you cannot project a dignified image on social media, do not do it. Also, do not try to use an alias, as someone will eventually find out. Regardless if today's application process seems like overkill, this is the world we now live in. It's true, HR has become an obnoxious bureaucracy, but these checks are designed to minimize the chances for a company to be sued. So you can thank the lawyers as well. Friends, keep the faith. This is Tim Bryce in Palm Harbor, Florida. Follow me on the internet at timbryce.com.